A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 28th Jan, on the front page you have Government sweetens Air India offer, puts 100% stake on the table. So Union Government has invited bids for 100% stake sale of Air India and transfer of management control along with its complete share in two subsidiaries. That is the low-cost international carrier Air India Express and the ground handling arm too, AISATS. So, government has offered to hive off even liabilities worth 40,000 crore to sweeten the deal. So, this is the second attempt by the present government to privatize the national carrier. Earlier, when in May 2018, the deadline for bids closed, not even a single private player had shown interest. So, now again, a step has been taken. You can see the comparison between 2018 and the 2020 deal offered. So, earlier it was 76% stake sale, now it is 100% stake sale offered. And debt also was only 15,000 crore of debt waivered. This is now 40,000 crore debt waivered. So, you can see. Then also, there was lack on clarity on employee entitlements. Now, it is said employee perks as such will be incurred on them. And data room to be opened during financial bids was what was stated in 2018. Now, it says 2020 that data room and draft share purchase agreements can be accessed in the first round itself. Means the bidders can see the details as such, you know, share purchase agreements, etc. in the first round itself. Then this is Citizenship Amendment Act rules expected to seek proof of religion. So government documents, could be sought from the applicants because Citizenship Amendment Act rules as such will come into effect. So the draft rules have been made and these are likely to seek documents from applicants that they entered India before December 31, 2014 and that they belong to the six religions exempted under the Act. So Assam government actually had asked the Ministry of Home Affairs to impose a 3-month time limit to apply under the CA and not keep it open-ended. So here you can see it is said that a religion document could be demanded. Then below you have West Bengal passes anti-CAA resolution. So a resolution against Citizenship Amendment Act has been passed by West Bengal now. Earlier we have seen three states already have passed such a resolution. First one was Kerala, second was Punjab, and then we saw Rajasthan too, and now West Bengal. Then here you have Center Assam government sign accord with Bodo groups to redraw renamed territory. So Ministry of Home Affairs, Assam government and the Bodo groups have signed an agreement to redraw and rename the Bodoland territorial area district in Assam. So presently it's spread over 4 districts in Assam. So as per the agreement, now villages dominated by Bodos that were presently outside would be included and those with non-Bodo population would be excluded. So, redrawing boundaries of this territorial area would happen and also territorial area district and also renaming it. So, this is finalized here, you can see. So, here you can see it would be renamed as Bodoland Territorial Region. On page 9, you have major gaps in our knowledge of coronavirus origin. So, this is regarding 2019 new coronavirus infection. So, it is known to cause severe respiratory illness, but it is said that we do not know much about its epidemiology, origin, duration of human transmission, and even the clinical spectrum of the disease need. So, these as such need to be studied. Future studies should concentrate on this, is what has been highlighted. And this is, why is a certificate needed to identify a trans person? So, Supreme Court has asked the government to explain why a law meant to protect the transgender community requires a magistrate certificate as a prior condition for the state to even identify a trans person. So, the petitioner, a trans person and a part of one of the first litigants for transgender rights in Bombay High Court, has contended the Transgender Protection of Rights Act of 2019 instead of furthering or protecting the fundamental rights of trans persons violates and facilitates the violation of their rights to life, privacy and equality. So we have seen this, the Act of 2019, the details have been done. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is crime and politics. So this is regarding how successive judgments to bar criminal candidates from contesting elections has done lately. So criminalization of politics is an issue on which Supreme Court also has adjudicated several times, but with no changes on the ground. So this article talks of that. And this is abolition politics. So this talks about how without consensus or policy, expediency dictates abolition and revival of councils. So this is about the legislative councils. So we have recently seen how Andhra Pradesh government is talking of abolishing the legislative council, but the proposal for such a case goes from the state legislature to the center, and central government has to take a final call. Then the lead article is retrieving the idea of citizenship. So this talks about how drawing on the preamble, people are occupying the constitutional commons to reclaim rights on freedom, justice. So this is regarding the protests which are going on against Citizenship Amendment Act. And this is a case of wholehearted biotechnology adoption. So it says, in biotech cotton in India, farmers have found a solution to some of their biggest on-field pest challenges. So, you know, how GM cotton, it covers 95% of area under cotton, and it is said there are no choices for farmers, but then this article counters such a view and says that Indian farmers have voted for choice of seeds with biotechnologies by planting hybrid cotton biotech seeds on over 90% of the country's cotton acreage. So they want seeds and technology that provide optimal yield, income and convenience in cultivation. So countering those arguments is what is being done in this article. They say that it is farmers who have found a solution in BT cotton and they are using it. But then there are problems with BT cotton too, which have been discussed quite often. Then on the op-ed page you have the tragedy of the regime's co-travelers. So this is regarding how the government is under crisis. If there are protests going on against the government, others are called upon to defend the government. Because when anti-CA protests were going on, then pro-CA protests were held. So there was no need for such a protest. It was just to counter the other protests. Then here you have assessing the NTCA protests. So this is regarding how protests are linked to Friday prayers as such. So this is called a strategic blunder in this article. So, on page 12 you have Muslim personal law, a cultural issue. So that this is what All India Muslim Personal Law Board told before the Supreme Court. It says constitution allows continuance of different practices of various religions. So it allows practices like polygamy and nikah halala, and these are called as cultural issues, and it is said they are inextricably interwoven with the religion of Islam. So but you should know that polygamy is not something which is mandated by Islam. So that is nothing which should be emphasized on to protect Islamic practices. On international page you have Chinese premier visiting virus hit Wuhan as toll rises to 81. So Prime Minister promises medical reinforcements and adequate market supply too. So we have seen how China has locked down the central city of Wuhan. The transport routes have been cut. Then this is Chinese tourists in Sri Lanka test positive for coronavirus. So Sri Lanka reported first case of coronavirus after a Chinese tourist tested positive. That is it. Then on business page you have this news regarding IndiGo, a budget airline, how its profits have soared threefold now. So this is not important for us. And here you have tougher norms likely for related party transactions. So this is actually a panel which was appointed by SEBI, Securities Exchange Board of India, the capital market regulator of the country. So this panel has proposed significant changes to strengthen the regulatory framework for related party transactions that have been subject of many corporate governance matters. So this working group as such was formed in November 2019 and it has proposed tweaking the definition of related party transactions as such. So it has called for change definition to change. That is, it should include transactions which are undertaken whether directly or indirectly with the intention of benefiting related parties. So if it benefits related parties, then it's a related party transaction. It also proposes an audit committee approval that it should be made mandatory for transactions between a listed entity or its subsidiary with its related party. Making norms stringent for related party transactions is what has been proposed here. So what is a related party? You can see the arm that any entity related to the promoter or promoter group should be considered a related party. Even an entity holding directly or indirectly along with their relatives 20% or more stake in a company should also be considered a related party. Then others are specific company related news which you can skip. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.